have a green roof design and installation company that also was starting around the same time as Eco Solutions, about 2.5 years ago. We also do ecological landscape design work, which takes place in gardens and all grounds as well. It's not just working on rooftops. This is an example of a green roof we did a few weeks ago out in Montauk. Also some examples of the type of plants that we work with. That's a native phlox. I'll talk a bit about why we work with native plants and also very effective drought tolerant plants that work for the rooftop environment. And as it's noted down below the photos, that some of the quick bullet points of benefits of green roofs is that we get cleaner air and water. So we get cleaner air because plants are very effective filters of air pollutants. They also take out pollutants from the water, but one of the main problems that we have in cities is water. Water has been treated as a gift from the heavens for thousands and thousands of centuries by different civilizations all over the world. But currently, in cities now, we treat water the same way we treat our garbage. It is waste. So when it rains, it's a waste disposal problem. Not really a solution to anything that we need. So the water in cities gets turned into runoff, which overflows our sewer system, creates an enormous amount of water pollution in the Hudson River, in our estuary, in the Gowanus, in Newtown Creek. Several of these places are extremely polluted, and we create about 27 billion gallons of raw, untreated sewage every single year. So when you have this problem with water, it's mostly because we've created such an impermeable landscape, which cities are. Cities are built using concrete, and that's something that we have to change when we want to look forward to a more sustainable city. So water is a real problem when you mix it with concrete, because the concrete's not absorbing it. The asphalt's not absorbing it. The roads, the parking lots, the rooftops are not absorbing it. So that's a real difference between soil medium and plants, trees, parkland, and concrete. That water gets absorbed. It can filter into our aquifer. I mean, not from a green roof, but on a park it can. On a rooftop, the water can be absorbed and then evapotranspired, which is part of the water cycle. So the water goes back into the air. It also cools. Plants are natural air conditioners. They cool the temperature of the air. And a green roof will also reduce the amount of energy consumed by your building, insulating it. It protects your roof from shielding it from UV rays and thermal shock. And some of the other benefits right now is there's a tax incentive that New York City provides, which is about 30% off of the installation cost, and also green collar jobs. Here's some other photographs of green roofs that we've done. This is one in East Village. I have a landscape design background and a certificate in biology conservation from Columbia, so a lot of what we try to focus on is creating natural habitat. So all of those benefits that I just listed about green roofs, there's one more benefit when you work with native plants. So you're creating natural habitat. New York City is on a huge migratory passageway for thousands of different types of species, monarch butterflies, bees, the great bees, recognized ones. Every season we have thousands of monarch butterflies in New York City. And birders love Central Park because there's so little natural landscape in New York City that all of the migratory species go straight to Central Park, and you can see them all in this very condensed area. So if we had more natural landscape, we would be able to support greater ecological productivity, these species that fly through our city, and also overwintering species, which there are several. This is some of the landscape design work we do on the ground. It's also very important what kind of plants you plant on the ground level, not just on the roof. There are several invasive species that are used on a regular basis by landscape designers that have serious impacts on our ecosystem. So working with natural plants that have evolved over the past 13,000 years since the last ice age in this area have a lot of benefits. You also have to water them less, you have to have less maintenance. There's a lot of cost privet and Japanese barberry and plants that are used in this corporate environment really become part of the concrete. Like, you don't see it anymore. You know, you don't see a lot of the landscape as nature. You don't even see them as plants because they're so overly designed. They're just part, they're so overused. So working with a natural aesthetic and bringing nature into the city and having people interact more with nature, I think is a really important part of green for the environment too. It's, as Andrew pointed out, how do people interact with this? I think that's very important. This is something that we're making too. There are planters that we make with recycled shredded paper and concrete.